We're going to take a look at the adizero adios pro 2, $220. It's available now, so only a year after the first version. We have a new version. The stack height's 39.5, 29.5, 10 millimeter drop. What we see is a significantly, at least for me, change midsole geometry with a gap on the medial side exposing the rods. We have a heel width that I measure 5 millimeters wider and the forefoot a millimeter wider. As a result, we see a 12 gram increase in weight in my 8.5 US to 8.2 ounces, 232 grams estimated in a 9. Wider, and we get a new upper. So what does it all translate to? Well, bottom line, this is a more accessible marathon super shoe, whereas the Pro 1 remains kind of your speedster. And of course, the elites will have the choice between the two. So I took them out for an A-B test. I'm going to talk about the fit, the ride. I also took them on a progression run. So please stay tuned to the video. Okay, everybody, I'm going to take the adizero adios Pro 1 over here out against the adizero adios Pro 2. I've tried them on. I haven't run yet side by side. I can say right away the Pro 2's toe box is considerably more voluminous. Doesn't feel quite as locked down over the toes. The kind of rubbery, hard to pull up tongue of the adios Pro 1 is replaced with a longer, much easier to adjust tongue. That's a good thing so far. They were quite a bit harder to pull on, and I think part of the reason is the higher tab compared to our version 1, but also these panels. You see the panels of overlays, quite thick panels really, towards the heel. Although the result is, so far before running, not quite the heel hold of the version 1. The other thing you will notice immediately is look how much more flared out and broader the outsole is, the midsole is here in the 2 versus the 1 with very vertical sidewalls. That sort of repeats itself at the heel. I'm going to show you underneath there's some changes.
And indeed, there are changes underfoot. The heel platform is 5 millimeters wider and more filled in. We have the gap for the energy rods on the medial side. And the forefoot is a millimeter or two wider with more flaring of the midsole.
So this feels like a broader platform up top and underneath. And in terms of weight, this is a US 8.5. 214 grams. This is the same size, 226 grams. So we gained 12 grams, and I suspect most of that probably coming from these slight changes to the midsole. Despite the fact we have that giant carve out, which we don't have in version 1. So the flaring. Let's see how they run.
Before we get to our A-B test, afterwards I took them on a progression run, about 8:17 pace, which would be on the faster end of my marathon pace, and I found the ride very consistent. I think the gap allows a smoother transition at all paces, even slower paces. You can see the upper there. You need to nicely match your socks. The cushioning is excellent. It's not as springy bouncy as, say, Zoom X or bouncy like the RC Elite, but it's very kind of stable and returns energy nicely, although the shoe does weigh a bit more than some of those competitors, but I really didn't notice it.
So I took them one on each foot, a fairly short run with gradually increasing the pace to a little faster than my marathon pace. So let's talk about the difference in the rides here. Well, definitely I found the Pro slightly softer with kind of a little bit more of a rebound sensation. Not sure if the foam is actually softer than the one. It kind of feels like it is. It's a little softer. But what I especially felt was a broader forefoot platform and more easy to find kind of the forward motion because of our gap here. That's something I really like.
in my favorite all-time racer is the original Vaporfly, the baby blue, which had kind of a sloppy upper that allowed you to kind of pronate forward down to the plate. And there is some of that same sensation here, even at slow paces. It was much easier to kind of roll along and get there than it was here. Also very important in looking at these two are the midsole sidewalls. I showed you that picture earlier. They're more flared at the front here in the two than in the one, where all the sidewalls are kind of vertical on both sides. You can see, if you line them up that way, you can see how much there's more flaring. It's not a lot, but it's noticeable. That creates that wider platform in the front. Slightly more stable heel. However, and I've got it on the medial side, if you pronate a lot, and we all pronate, but if you have a pronation issue, I'm not sure the combination of the upper and the gap is going to be for you, because we have a definitely have a roomier upper here. At first, I thought before I took them out that the hold might not be adequate, but it is. Not quite as good as the one for me. Not sure why, really, because look at that look at that kind of broader collars. If you compare the two, it may be the overall kind of grid of cellar mesh, and also maybe we have a bit more padding here, although we have those panels. So a little bit better hold with the one standing around, but once I got going, I kind of reached the conclusion that there are really two shoes here. Our Pro One, for me, and I think many non-pro runners, is going to be your 5 to 10K to half shoe. For me, I don't think I'd go, I think I'd prefer this for the half and above, because it's a more taut ride. It's a little harder to transition at slower paces because we have the filled in area comparatively. It has kind of more response, but and it's not the rebound of the foam, it's more overall platform. It's a little firmer, it's a little kind of narrower and more arrow shaped. So this is kind of the speed sibling to the marathon sibling, at least the way I'm feeling it so far. They're both excellent shoes, so that extra weight I talked about, I think, is really coming from our foam being our geometry being more flared, and most likely of all because we have 5 millimeters more width at the heel and the cavity back there being more filled in. Underfoot, of course, it's very, very different between underfoot, it's very different between these two, as we have the rods exposed, whereas here it's all filled in. So let's talk a teeny bit more about our uppers here. They're really, I think, quite different in materials and hold. This is a mono mesh, similar to the Skechers, with underlays. You can see the whites throughout. There is no gusset tongue. Over here in the one, we have a grid and a sort of consistent inner grid of the cellar mesh. Over here, it's thinner. I didn't have the issues pulling it up and the folding that I do over here. It's a little longer, a little thinner, and there is no gusset. I think it works a little better. However, if you're a pronating type runner, you might appreciate the support here from our little gusset in the mix. And the gusset is hard to see, but it's actually a rubbery material down quite a ways down there. There you can see it. Whereas here we have none whatsoever. So in terms of breathability, they're both excellent. Here we have a perforated sock liner. Here we don't. I kind of prefer, I think, even it's a super humid day, almost 100% humidity, I think the two's upper is a bit more breathable, but they're really very breathable in that sense. Now, we have a full multi-tester review already on the site. I'm going to try to run some more in them and actually race them. But Jamie and Jacob and Ivan over in Denmark are all much faster than me these days, have all tested and reviewed it, and there were a number of comparisons. I'll add one more here. Before I ran today in our Adios Pro 2, I ran basically the same 3-mile loop with a pickup in the New Balance Fuel Cell Elite RC2, and the differences are quite striking. The RC Elite 2, I'll show you a picture, is much bouncier. It's more forgiving. You could almost call it a trainer, really, and I would train in it regularly. So it's kind of the friendliest super shoe, but this one here gets mighty, mighty close in terms of being friendlier than the original. Maybe not quite as fast for the super fast and the short, but it's a really nice contender. I think as I get more into it, I'm going to appreciate that gap, which allows the foot, and I'll show you how the foot, to move and kind of collapse forward more with the upper playing in towards toe off on the big toe. That's kind of key. And I felt the rods were a little easier to find, maybe not quite as snappy as over here. So please stay tuned. We're going to have some more. Another video review after I kind of run some more, but you'll find lots of information over our linked review in the description. Multi-tester review of the adizero Adios Pro 2 with lots more comparisons. Thank you very much for watching.